We are here to honor heroes who lost their lives in the line of duty. Men and women who put themselves in the way of danger so that the rest of us could live in safety. There were beat cops, deputies, detectives, correctional and Forest Service officers, federal agents, and tribal police. But to many here today, they went by different titles. Caring husband, loving wife, my son, my daughter, mom, dad. And so to all the families who are here today, whose loved ones did not come home at the end of a shift, please know how deeply sorry we are for the loss that you've endured. Know how deeply grateful we are for your loved one's sacrifice. We hold them up as heroes because that's what they are. It takes a special kind of courage to be a peace officer, to be the one people turn to in their most desperate moments, to be willing to run into a dangerous situation when everybody else is running the other way. Scripture tells us to love our neighbors as we love ourselves, but only a special few take that commandment so deeply to heart that they are willing to risk their lives so that others, often total strangers, can know peace and security. And that's what peace officers do. And today we honor 131 who made that ultimate sacrifice. Your jobs are inherently dangerous. The reminders are too common. Just a few days ago, two police officers were killed in the line of duty in Mississippi. A week before that, an officer was killed in the line of duty in Queens. A few months before that, two of his fellow officers in the NYPD were killed as well. We cannot erase every darkness or danger from the duty that you've chosen. We can offer you the support you need to be safe. We can make the communities you care about and protect safer as well. We can make sure that you have the resources you need to do your job. We can do everything we have to do to combat the poverty that plagues too many communities in which you have to serve. We can work harder as a nation to heal the rifts that still exist in some places between law enforcement and the people you risk your lives to protect. We owe it to all of you who wear the badge with honor. And we owe it to your fellow officers who gave their last full measure of devotion. Most of all, we can say thank you. We can say we appreciate you. And we're grateful for the work that you do each and every day. And we can thank the families who bear the burden alongside you. On behalf of the American people, I offer the families, friends, and fellow officers of those we've lost my prayers and my deepest thanks. We could not be prouder of them, more grateful for their service. We could not be prouder of you and all who work so hard to keep us safe. May God bless and keep the fallen. May He comfort the mourning. May He protect the peacemakers. And may He bless the United States of America.